pattern is designed to fold under pressure, so you're comfortable even if you're sitting on your wallet or keys.
Chicken dinner! Got them in the butt!
Go to purple.com and see why people are saying, like sitting on cloud nine. Sweet derriere relief. I forgot I've been sitting for 8 days. Try it for 30 days. And if your buns aren't blown away, they'll take it back for a full refund. No questions asked. Yeah, life can be a pain in the butt, but you don't have to stand for it. You can sit. The purple seat cushion. More portable than the Switch. Game over, numbut.
Shit. Oh, geez, this is so gross, man. So, I probably should have cleaned up a little bit. So, I mean, you want me to tell you about everything?
Yeah.
All right, so this is my underground ninja lair, right? This is where I stream. Jess is upstairs. My wife, she hangs out there, does all the management stuff up here, and I'm down here kind of lurking. This is not where I sleep. This is just a guest bed for family and friends when they come over. As you can see, I'm a Lions fan. She's a Packers fan, so we have this cool little carpet that says a house divided. I think that's pretty nifty. This is my green screen that I never use. Pardon the mess, but it's just everything I've collected throughout my entire streaming career. My YouTube 100,000 subscriber plaque. So it takes like a week or two to arrive. I claimed this when I was at like 3 million subscribers, and now I'm at 6 million. Oh, dude, yeah, man, these boots are my Goku Rose cosplay stream I did. So this is when my hair was pink.
This is about as lighthearted as the stream is gonna get.
Yeah, so I wore these all stream. Okay. Pain is beauty, you know? Fun fact, this is my fiber that I have built in to my house. I had to pay a lot of money for it. And then this is it. This is where I game, this is where I stream. This is the bandana that I rock every time I win. This is actually one of my favorite things that I've started to do is when I win a game, I will put the bandana on. It actually sucks because when I die and I have to take it off, I always feel like just demoralized. Like, I just got shit on and I just throw it away.
And there he is, Myth, getting set up on stage to join in with Heat 3. Folks in the venue, make some noise for Myth as he gives his best effort to take down Ninja here. As, I'm sure everyone is quite familiar with Myth and his presence, but can you explain maybe for people who don't know exactly who Myth is, why is this such a big deal?
Like I said before, I had the chance to hang out with Myth when we were out at PSX in Anaheim. A super, super down-to-earth kid.
Yeah.
Very, very good at the game. Terrifyingly good at the game. And I think a couple people have seen that firsthand. One goes by the name of Summit. The two of them had the opportunity to run into each other in solos a number of times, and I don't think Summit enjoyed the outcome. Just the building skill that Myth has shown, every time people tune in the stream, it's always the go-to. He's so fast.
Yeah.
It's terrifyingly fast, I'll tell you that. I've had the opportunity to run into him a couple times in game, and it did not end up well for me if he got the drop. Let's just say that.
And we've seen some great building today. But the fact that we're still expressing just how good his building is after all the great building we've seen so far, you really haven't seen anything yet.
Exactly. Now, before we keep going, we do have let's look at a collection of highlights from Heat 1 and Heat 2. Kind of go over, talk about what's going on, and we'll move on from there.
Absolutely. We'll take a look here in just a brief moment. One thing we know so far, Ninja's gotten a hell of a lot of kills. We'll take a look from the best ones from the first couple heats here. So it was all the way back in the very beginning. Remember this hunting rifle play and the crossbow player up on the mountain? So he went to go take him down here. And it's been fun to watch him adapt as the games have gone on. But I talked to him. It's going to sound a little bit weird. I just caught up with him in the bathroom. But he said, I just want one more win. I want one more win. He's happy he has won, but he wants to be the king of one of these lobbies, especially with Myth now in play.
I think if he plays like he has, you'll see as we go through these the game one highlights, and he gets taken out there at the last second. The confidence in his play, the speed at which he's building, it's going up every time.
Yeah.
And if he keeps that going, if that's the trend that he can hold on to, it's only up from here. The last heat is coming up, blind right there, you see. You even hear the crowd in the background going crazy with that shot. Blind, took advantage of maybe an opportunity where Ninja wasn't as confident, but Heat 1, Game 2, you can see he had a much better setup to start this game. The purple scar, clearly streamer perks activated, and he started just hitting some shots with a pump.
And I think this is the game where he really learned that he could never expect to be safe, especially after a fight. He thought he had a moment to breathe in this one, and that really wasn't the case.
Yeah. You'll see here in a sec, he's going to get caught off guard from a pump shotgun, or maybe it was a heavy from above here, just because as he edits his way through here, trying to find a safe spot, he goes to the bottom of his own
Portafort,
and forgets that it's still open up top. Nibs takes advantage of it and gets the kill. And I think that's a mistake he won't make again.
Absolutely. And then moving in towards game one of Heat 3, this moment, one of the closest.
Dodging the trap.
Remember, we brought up that the bounty was there. That player was dead already. That trap nearly got a kill for him when he wasn't even alive, which would have been quite the hysterical story.
He's had a number of doubles now, double kills, that, as the games have gone on. Because I think his awareness is catching up to where he's used to it being.
Yeah.
Maybe not. You never know. He's a great player, but could be getting caught off guard by everybody that's here just to watch this event. Saint there getting a rocket kill through. Maybe an attempt to block at the ramp.
And that was smart from Saint. There was just the fight from Ninja. Didn't give him a chance to heal or breathe. Then we moved into Heat 2. And all we talked about was, I'm worried for the members of Heat 2 and what could go on now that Ninja's warming up. And this moment right here is when you noticed his build was clean.
Oh, yeah. You see, this is the second double kill. Like you said, stepping into Heat 2, definitely I think the pace, the tone of his own gameplay changed, and he knew that. And you could tell just the way he was being more aggressive, pushing players when he had the opportunity to. He knew what he had going for him. Right there, hitting the shot.
That's
wins
the whole
game. Yeah.
That's the whole game. If he misses that pump, that rocket instantly kills him, and Ninja doesn't get the victory, but he winds up clutch getting there. You saw it
just stand up right here. There it is.
That was the relief of I won one at my own event. Obviously, pom-pom with Jess, which is always great. And you can tell there's a little bit of a weight lifted off him when he went and used the bush.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
You know, moving forward, he was feeling good, but I think he's locked back in now, Lupo.
E2 game two, looking down from above. This landing at containers, which typically is not a super active place. He even made note of this himself. He said, you don't expect to see a whole lot of people there, and it seemed like there were far more than anyone would have anticipated. He got a really good shot there in Turkey Jerky. The pump action closed the deal on that one. Moving into Heat 2, game 3.
This was his weakest performance of all up to this point. You see some of our reactions as it happened.
Good,
but
honestly. Like,
the final moment
the
here. My goodness. Look at how crazy this was. That storm doing so much damage.
Incredible. Pain taking home that one for Temple Storm.
And here it is. A breakdown of everything up to this point. Games 1 and 2. It was Blind coming out on top, winning a total of, I believe, $7,500. You saw Saint Bear as well get involved. The Ninja won that game 4, which gave $2,500 to the Alzheimer's Association. And again, Ninja so far playing quite well up to this point.
Now, I've had the opportunity to know Ninja for a while now. We met in PUBG a number of months ago. I think it was last May, a grenade that was cooked that I'll never forget. But from that stemmed a friendship that honestly is kind of unmatched.
Yeah.
But I've seen him grow, man, from where he was in PUBG to where he is now, and yeah, just the journey that he's gone on is it's been incredible. And we'd like to take a look at it real quick.
Hi, I'm Tyler Ninja Blevins, and I'm a professional streamer and gamer and stuff. This is like test, right? Or is this real?
No, it's real.
Oh, okay, my bad. You need to do it one more time? Okay, no, got it. Okay, I can just keep going. I can just cut this. And, yeah, I don't know. This is weird. Hi, I'm Tyler Ninja Blevins, and I am a streamer on Twitch and YouTuber.
Comunicación, por favor, ayúdame.
I've been streaming for 6 years, almost like 7. Everything's kind of just evolved.
My other
God,
channel, there was
no.
Wrong with it, like the AdSense, and I accidentally deleted it.
I've been ready for this forever.
There are reports that you're making more than $500,000 a month.
I would say every week is like a 10,000 viewer increase. I'm streaming in front of like hundreds of thousands of people all the time, playing at a dominant level.
It's just built and built and built and built.
I mean, the other day, I think we peaked at 185,000, and that's just like nutty.
Probably like whisk this up and maybe add a little bit of peanut butter to it. Oh, and then soy sauce. Cannot forget that.
Okay. Jess and I met like 8 years ago in La Crosse, Wisconsin at a Focus Fire tournament.
We got there and I remember seeing Tyler and I was like, who is is that guy? He's so cute. And
she was super hot. I mean, I no, honestly, I saw her immediately, but I was too nervous to say anything. So
I mean, if you would have told me that I was looking at my future husband, I would have been like, you're crazy. This looks so delicious.
That's
I think
awesome.
We should add some peppermint.
Okay.
Yeah, so this is Navi. She just jumped up. She just jumped up in the middle of the interview. Yeah, this is our newest dog. I proposed to my beautiful wife with this dog. I put a ring around her collar the first day we got her.
Yes.
Oh yeah, Jessica, what does she mean to me? I mean, I wouldn't be here without her at all. I mean, she brought balance into a world where I needed it, and she's enhanced like everything that I have been and have been able to do.
Oh my gosh, so cute. Wow, this is young Ninja. This was foreshadowing.
Yeah, I have, that's a katana from my brother Chris's Halloween costume that year. So I started getting into gaming when I was just a little kid. My dad played video games, and he brought them into the house.
Do you remember what games you would ever play with him?
Oh, the one I remember the most was Madden, like the NFL Blitz or something like that.
Really?
And he would always be like, here comes the Blitz! And then he would blitz me every time, and I would just throw the ball away. And 5 years old, I had no idea what I was doing. He's picking on his little kid.
Here comes the blitz.
My parents did a really good job of raising me. My brothers always keep me in check as well. They came up with a song. My brothers had a song for me my last couple of years of like high school.
Really?
Oh yeah, yeah. It's the worst song in the world. It's like obsession, disgrace. It is as plain as the game in your face. Obsession. And they would just repeat it over and over again.
Oh my gosh, bullying.
I've always had faith in myself that I could be like one of the largest streamers on the platform, but I think it's now starting to transcend that. I think that is what's exciting to me. We guys having a wonderful Thursday, right? There was just this day where it just took off. I was streaming, it was like 11 a.m. or something, and my entire chat is just like, Champagne Poppy followed you. I'm like, who's Champagne Poppy? They're like, Drake, 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 Drake. So I go on Instagram and I type in Drake and nothing pops up. So I'm like, oh, Champagne Poppy, 40 million followers follows me. I'm like, okay. Like, I mean, I sat there with Jess and my wife, and I'm just like, this is happening. Like, no one hacked his account, right? Like, this is actually happening.
Hi, Drake.
Hi, how are you? Can you hear me?
Yeah, she can hear you.
Oh, yeah, all right. What's up?
He's just doing a backflip real quick. Sorry.
Yo, I've been watching you for a minute, man. I saw you guys win a crazy, like, competition. And, like, that.
You saw that? Nice, yeah. Dude. He's a great teammate, by the way. Dropped me a bunch of wood and stone all the time. I mean, he knew who was going to carry him to victory, which was great. Let me know if he's reviving his teammate.
Yeah, he is. He is. He's reviving his teammate.
Got it, baby.
Yeah.
Boom.
There we go. Let's get it, man.
Let's go, baby.
Canadian rapper Drake helped Ninja shatter the record for most concurrent viewers on Twitch.
I definitely try to not pay attention to how many people are watching. Oh, that's 100,000 people. That's like two Ford Fields. You know, maybe I'd start joking a little bit. Bro, I can't hit a shot. I can't hit a shot. Bomb. Throws another nade. Knocks him. And that's the game. I want to continue to grow and be like one of the largest names out there, but that's simply just because I want to spread a lot of positivity in a world. You can blow up and you can be all over the place on Instagram, Twitter, but if you're not doing something positive with it, that's irrelevant. I started streaming, you know, when I was 18 or 19 years old, playing Halo. Some guy was just like, hey, I want you to stream.
Yeah, feel lucky, Wilson. Yeah. Come on. Just want to play some Halo.
And then it kind of just took off. I was already in the competitive scene, so I had like 50 viewers right off the bat. And then PUBG came out. I started averaging like 5,000, 10,000 viewers in that game. And then Fortnite comes out. And it was not blowing up. No big streamers hopped on board. And I was like, this game definitely is going to be it. And I saw it. And then I started playing it. And then it was just over.
First impression of the game. It's fun. I just honestly still don't know how to shoot in this game. I'm bad. I'm so bad. I can't believe it.
I remember I came out with this moment
on stream where I was like, my viewers were starting to increase a little bit, but my subscriber count was dipping, you know, tremendously. And I literally remember the turning point of my entire career was when I addressed my stream and I was just like, you need to understand that I love this game, but like a lot of these people who are watching me play Fortnite, like no one is like supporting the channel, no one is subscribing. I can't keep playing this game if you guys don't support me. And that day alone, I think I gained like 1,000 subscribers. And then after that, it was over. So I've gained 8 million subscribers on YouTube in like 4 months, 5 months. I went from 1.8 million followers on Twitch to 5.8 million, 200,000 followers on Twitter to 1.6 million, 20,000 on Instagram to 3 million in 6 months. Everyone here seems super excited about the event, and I'm excited as well. And I've met a lot of the players as well, and they're just super excited to be here, man, and just get a chance to play Fortnite, you know, against me. And I'm pumped. I'm hoping that I can, you know, perform very well.
It is time. We are back for our final heat live from the Esports Arena in Las Vegas. This is such a beautiful sight outside right now. The scenic view of the Luxor Hotel and Casino. And we're back for one final heat, Lupo. What a day it's been so far here at Ninja Vegas 18.
It's been incredible. Heat 3 coming up moments away. Notable players. We'll start from the bottom. Sicarios, Vape Jesus, Schmalti, 7th, and the man, the legend, I had to do it a different order because it's Myth. A lot of people have been waiting
this
for this matchup for a while. Myth, a very, very popular player, crazy big on Twitch. These two going against each other, is there anything else you can think of in Fortnite that might make you a little...
This is the absolute biggest thing. This is one of the biggest Fortnite moments so far, and speaking so much of Myth, we actually have him on the stage with Jess.
You guys, besides Ninja, I think tonight the one guy everybody's been waiting to see play is TSM Myth over here. Can I hear it in the house? How many of you guys are here waiting for Myth to do some domination tonight? Thank you so much, Myth, for coming out. How are you feeling coming into this final heat trying to destroy Ninja?
I feel really, really confident in my ability to do that task. I think something that I'm super, like, so the main feeling that I'm feeling right now is, like, super anxious. I just want to get up there and just, like, play, like, never mind this interview, let me just on there, you know? But that's, like, those are my feelings pretty much so far.
True pro player here, just ready to get in there and play. I know Tyler was saying hours ago, like, I'm just ready to get in there and play. I have to ask you how this cookies and cream duo that, like, I live with them. I don't even know how this name came about. So tell me a little bit about the cookies and cream Ninja Myth.
So cookies and cream developed, I think it may have been the second or first time we actually duoed. And I think we were rapping or something, and then, like, it was either me or Ninja, like, we spit a bar, and then Cookies and Cream kind of just came up as a thing there. And now, like, we've, like, brain-blasted ideas of, like, okay, we need our own animated series. We need our own comics, Cookies and Cream. Like, let's do it. So it's developed into something so much more, which is awesome.
It's so great. It's, like, my favorite ice cream, and I'm also waiting for merch to come out on his shows, on his site. So it's so great. You've also been streaming here from the Esports Arena. So is this your first weekend here? And if it is, how has your experience been streaming live?
Yeah, so this has been my first time in Vegas, like, ever. And, yeah, the first time at the Esports Arena as well. And it's been a wonderful time. Yeah, like, having people behind you and watching you live as well is something that's super awesome. Like, being able to see the people and meet people that interact with your stream on a day-to-day basis is something that's super humbling and awesome opportunity.
Right, and you've had an absolutely incredibly successful stream that's just been growing, so congratulations on that. Out of these next three games, how many do you think you're gonna win?
What I really, really wanna do is, like, minimum two. Like, I wanna win minimum two games and go for the twofer. But I think I could definitely get one.
Well, good luck, and thank you so much for coming out to support this event, Myth. Thank you, guys.
Wow, the man himself. You hear the confidence. Here's the all-time kills on PC leaderboards, and we've highlighted two of them. Ninja in the fifth spot,
Myth in the seventh spot.
Popularity is one thing, but being able to look directly at this, just the amount of time and dedication it takes to get to these kind of numbers is insanity. Cypher, King Richard, you see a lot of other big names up there, but Ninja and Myth so close together. 2,000 might seem like a lot, but fifth and seventh, that's an incredibly even matchup in terms of eliminations in the game. So this goes this goes beyond just popularity. These two players are actually pretty evenly matched, which is scary to say that there's two people that are out there that are that good.
And you heard Myth say he wants to win two of these next three games.
That's confidence. Right? That's scary confidence. But
Ninja himself said he just wanted to win one. And no. Out there
he's
going two.
He's looking for 66% win rate, and I think he can do it.
Yeah, and Myth isn't the only notable person in this final heat. There's so many great players. Actually, one team that has three members represented in this final heat is Tempo Storm, and we actually have one of their members down on the floor for a quick interview.
That is correct, Courage. We just heard from one pro gamer in Myth, but right now we have Tempo Storm's Vape Jesus with us. So do we have any Tempo Storm fans in the house? Now, during that interview with Myth, you shared to me that you really, really like him a lot. Can you share with us why that is?
Well, I kind of started playing the game because I watched Myth, a long time ago when the first starter came out. And since then, I just put so much time into the game, I wouldn't have made it here without, watching a stream. So it's in a way, I thank him for where I am, So that's why I really respect him.
So how crazy is it for you for everything to kind of come full circle now? You're playing the same heat as him. You might go up against him 1v1. How does that feel?
It feels incredible, honestly. It's an honor to play with a lot of the players that are here. Everybody that's here, I fully respect. It's a lot of good teams and a lot of good players. I'm just super happy to be here.
Well, we're already in Heat 3 now, Heats 1 and 2. We saw your teammates. Payne finally got a win for Tempo Storm. So how was it for you watching your teammates?
Oh, it was incredible. It was incredible watching Payne and Winter work. Winter had was a little unlucky, but Payne brought it home for us. Super happy. Glad he stuck to the plans. He did it, he brought the win home.
And it's funny because when I spoke to Payne, he actually mentioned that he completely changed his style to actually emulate you. So does that give you sort of a boost of confidence headed into this heat?
Yeah, the shout out kind of hit my heart. I love Payne. It's great to see that I can teach my team more because I'm an in-game leader. So it's kind of nice that I feel like I'm teaching them something. Yeah.
Well, we absolutely love the camaraderie. Best of luck as this heat starts. Let's head over to the casters.
All right, we are about to be there again. Here are the participating players from Tempo Storm in the heats, and we saw Winter. He mentioned him. We saw Payne get a victory, but now three of them represented in this final one. You got to give Tempo Storm some props for sending so many members out here.
They're definitely trying to make a good impression by having a lot of, and all their players are really, really good, terrifyingly good.
Yeah.
So the fact that Payne could take it home in heat two for Tempo Storm once is fantastic. I mean, it definitely puts a strong light on Tempo Storm, and three players in this last heat, I gotta say, one of them's gotta show up, right? That many people in one pot.
For sure. Oh, no, if they go home not winning one of these, I think they'll be upset with themselves. But it's time to begin Heat 3, and as you guys know, we've gotta select two players to play up on stage alongside Ninja. He's ready on the floor to get that process done.
Yes, yes, yes. Hi, guys. Okay, so are we good? Am I ready? Okay, unfortunately, we had a little bit of a snafu going on with the last time we had a player who was called after we rolled, so we're actually going to pull up seat number 48, the guy who should have been up here last game. Where is he? Where is he? Right here? What's up, buddy? Ready? Let's go. Come on up. I'll hold your hand. Walk your station, man. Good luck, buddy. All right. And then also, all right, again, we're in Vegas, baby, another casino. Let's spin that wheel, boys. Let's see who's going to be joining us up here. 16. And where's 16? 16 on this side, this side, this side, this side, this side. Who's the lucky winner, man? Oh my God, look at him. He's just cute. It's just cool as a cucumber. What's up, buddy? Hey, I got you, man. I got you. And then where's he? Is he at the end or is he right here? All right, yo, hey, good luck, dude. Good luck. I love the shirt, dude. Pineapples, that's mine, man. My hair, my guy. Turn around. I got you, brother. You kid. You want to switch? All right, guys, this is the final heat. We got three more matches going on, and I just want some good competition, man. All right, so thank you guys so much for coming out again, and let's get ready for Heat 3. Woo!
Here it is, Heat 3 about to begin, and man, the stage is set between the talented Tempo Storm players
Obviously, Myth now being involved, and now Ninja again looking for his second victory. We have to keep in mind that final game with the heightened bounty. We're at the extra $5,000. You kill Ninja, $7,500 in that final game. You win, obviously, another $25. Still so much money up for grabs.
The other thing that could potentially play out, if things are really going to build up here, if Ninja wins game one and game two of this heat, that's a $2,500 rollover, another $2,500 rollover. We could be looking at $12,500 for an elimination on Ninja in game nine.
And I know more and more people are tuning in. Over 500,000 watching online. If you're just tuning in, here is the recap so far. You see Ninja himself got eliminated the first three games by both Blind and then Saint, but then Ninja took that game four, which, again, the charity side of this event. When Ninja wins, $2,500 goes to the Alzheimer's Association. Unfortunately, that's the only game so far that he has secured the victory in. Now looking for potentially a second here. As the last time he applied chapstick, he won. He's now applying chapstick again. I'm changing my vote. Ninja's winning this next game.
I'm surprised he doesn't have the bandana on as well. You know, build confidence. Anything he could do to push things up.
Wow, a cosplay as the Love Angel.
Incredible.
Absolutely brilliant. I think I purchased you for $20 in the shop, so that was what the V-Bucks was. But again,
Russ Lord.
So he instantly kills any knocked out teammate of mine. That's the guy.
The thirstiest skin that
exists.
That's
the guy. I'm going to talk to you after the event is over, and there's the dance as well, but that's awesome. The Fortnite cosplays. No one cosplaying as Ninja, though. No one with the dyed hair. And look, Myth, you can just tell how on edge he is as he yawns, getting ready for this next game. But we should be good to go. That's absolutely awesome. They're getting selfies done as well.
Selfie complexity. You can see the strat there to turn the phone. Top tier plays.
Ninja, what's going on down there? Oh,
we're good. Good. Nice to meet you guys. What's up, guys? Nice to meet you guys. Fine. I had to get a picture of this. Hey, what's up, man? How you doing, man? What's up, guys? Dude, you see these guys cosplaying over here? Looks so good, man. I had to get over just get a picture real quick before the game started. Priorities.
No, it makes sense. It makes sense.
No one blames you. Don't worry.
I think you're more excited to meet them than they were to meet him, the cosplayers.
I love anyone that's passionate about stuff like that, man. That's so cool to be able to. I mean, that guy's also jacked as all hell, man. So
yeah, right.
He's pulling it off, dude.
Nah, he ripped me in half. But again, we should be ready to go for Heat 3. The last game wasn't your best one, though, Ninja.
No, it was the worst one.
And now I'm ready to see you get your vengeance.
Courage literally lighting Ninja on fire
on
stage
honestly,
right now.
Is it just me, or is my ass on fire? Because I feel like you're just roasting me, dude.
He did.
I'm taking some jabs while I can. I'm
absolutely
doing Lupo's job.
No, this is going to be a great Heat, man. I know that. When Myth did say, yeah, I'm thinking two. I'm thinking not. Okay. All right. Sorry, if I ever see that little skull trooper running around rotating, you put your ass up. I'm going to be taking a little pot shots at him, making sure he's weak.
You think he's going to run the skin that he typically does?
There's no reason. I don't really see. He's too confident. I know he doesn't care about that stuff. I'm pretty sure he'll run it.
I have a question for you.
Yeah.
Summit went on stream, stated openly saying that a lot of competitive players know all the skill in the game is based on the skin you run.
Yes.
Sometimes skins have bad days. Do you think that's going to play into your skin choice during Heat 3?
I don't know if you can see what I'm rocking right now, dude, but I'm just messing around.
All right.
You'll see it.
I think I might have an idea of what his strategy is.
Oh, dude, it is pay to win, though. Everyone knows that, man. If you have a good skin, you know, it's all about that intimidation factor.
Epic employees watching right now are cringing.
Literally ready.
He's kidding, folks. The skins give you no benefit other than looking cool. And making you feel better about yourself.
It's true.
We are just a couple minutes away from starting Heat 3. I can see the viewer count continue to climb. Again, folks, tweet out the stream. You can watch at two different locations, twitch.tv/ninja and twitch.tv/esportsarena. As we get things sorted, it looks like Myth is speaking with one of our referees. In your opinion, Dr. Lupo, who gets the first victory between Ninja and Myth right here?
What if it's no one?
One of you guys is going to win. I'm making that statement.
Okay.
I think at this point, Ninja has an advantage in confidence alone.
Okay.
He's played on the stage before. And so in front of all these people, he has an opportunity to capitalize on that.
For
where
sure.
Myth maybe gets a little shaky at first. We'll see, though.
Has Myth ever competed at an event like this before? I don't know.
I think this is the first time for a lot of people.
Ninja, do you know if Myth's ever competed in something?
I don't think he's in competitive esports before this. I think I talked to him when we very first streamed. I think he's – what did he play? He played like Okay, he played Minecraft, I think. Wait, you did Minecraft? What was the game that you grinded before this? What was it? Paragon.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and there weren't any competitive tournaments for Paragon that I know of that had local tournaments or anything like that. But, I mean, when you're streaming, dude, you kind of get that. You need to, like, build up a tolerance, right, to competing in front of a bunch of people, not letting the nerves get to you.
Yeah.
And I think that when you do stream, it is especially for his age, being able to play in front of that many people, I think there's going to be two things. He's either going to dominate or he might start off slow.
What happened to the bandana?
Oh, I took it off. It was actually just a little warm, making my head just a little bit warmer. I want to put it on if I win.
That's true.
Now, yeah. There's a fun fact that I just got word of, and maybe you can confirm this for me, Ninja. So, word on the street is that if you have Twitch Prime and you sub to the Ninja channel right now, you might not even realize that you have it available.
That's
but
true,
you
man.
Could go and click the sub button at home. A lot of people have Amazon Prime. You can link it together, and for every sub that Ninja gets during Heat 3, it boosts the chance that he's going to win. Do you know if that's true or not?
I heard rumors, man. I really didn't think that that we were going to announce the Twitch Prime subscriptions while live streaming, integration, increasing my luck in this game, right? But, I mean, since the secret's out,
I figured,
right?
I'd let him know, man.
Yeah, I mean, it's really cool, man. So if you guys do want me to win, man, just that little subscribe button. By the way, if you ever create your username, you look at it, it's beautiful, right? If you create a username on Twitch, and this is just for everyone, this is not just me. If we have any people who are out here who are huge fans of other streamers, like, create a username, and you have one free Twitch Prime month trial where you can subscribe and support their stream. It doesn't have to be me. It can be to anyone. It can be Dr. Lupo Courage. There's a bunch of good streamers out there, and there's a lot of people that just don't know that there are free ways to support these channels. And like what you guys said earlier, linking an Amazon Prime account to a Twitch, until that Amazon Prime runs out, you get Twitch Prime. So support all streamers on Twitch and just, you know, help everyone live the dream.
We got our plug. It's time to leave. Let's head out.
Based on everything I'm seeing, you're going to win every game play for the rest of the year.
I'm voting for Ninja for everything. Okay,
you guys are amazing.
Last three. I want to see this bounty climb, though, again, just to set the stage as we head into this final heat. We're back to, you get a kill on Ninja, it's $2,500. You win the game, it's $2,500. But that final one, that heightened $5,000 involved in the last game. How are you feeling right now yourself, Tyler? Yeah. It's been a long week for you.
I'm just blessed, man.
Okay.
I feel great. I'm ready for this. I've always been ready for stuff like this. And to see all these people who are coming here to just get the chance to play and play against me and just with me is incredible. It's, you know, I'm just having a blast.
Yeah.
And thank you guys for coming as well, man. You guys are a big part
of
it.
Of course. No, I'm honored to be here. It's been an
absolute
blast. I wouldn't miss
the chance to see you lose live in front of all these people. Are you kidding me?
Thanks, man. Appreciate it.
Don't be ridiculous.
It's classic Dr. Lupo.
But no, we've had a blast. I got to give you props, Dr. Lupo. You crushed it for your first ever cast. Thankfully, I've been lucky to do events in the past, but I think this is the most viewed event I've ever done.
Oh, I appreciate it.
Crazy, and I can only imagine what it was like for you. But you got the personality.
So, if you guys don't mind me asking, how much are you guys paying me to put that on your guys' resume? Because, I mean, that's going to boost that resume up there for the future.
Listen, all right, we traded for the Twitch Prime plugs.
You're right. I owe you guys, honestly, at this point.
Thanks. We'll have dinner after this at 11.
On me.
There you go. Perfect.
I got
perfect.
You.
But, yes, we are just moments away getting a couple things sorted. I think, actually, we just pressed the start game button to join up in the lobby. So that means we are here. We are at Heat 3. It is time to begin. I'm going to give a round of applause and make some noise for yourselves out there. This crowd has been awesome tonight. They've been having a blast here at the Esports Arena in Las Vegas. And now it's time for the final three games.
We got over 700 people here in person. We got over half a million.
I literally thought you were about to say we have over 700 people watching online.
I think there are over 700 people. Over a half million people watching on Twitch right now. That's incredible.
Yeah.
That's a couple people, I think.
That's just a few. Just a few. But here we go. You see the look of the players on the stage. I'm sure you can hear the sounds in the background. The battle bus is soaring. And
there we go.
Is out.
Looking like a walking tomato right now.
He's gone ahead and switched things up again.
Like you said earlier, the skin honestly is like 90% of the skill.
Yes.
Ninja's kind of just along for the ride, and people know that.
Again, going to one of these more secluded landings, and it doesn't surprise me. I think he really loves the fact that when he goes to spots like this, he can count
even on one hand how many players there are near him. You know, he can go, there's one guy that can push from here, there's one guy that can push from here, and it gives him peace of mind to know exactly, you know, what to expect. He's not overwhelmed off the break like when you land at a major city.
Doing his due diligence to farm up a little bit, but he's got to keep an eye out for a weapon, especially if by some chance he didn't catch any players coming in and there was one. He's going to pick up the blue pump, a big gun to get this early in the game, especially when most likely no one else has shields.
We continue on through off the break of this one. It's Ninja just farming things up. Getting that pump as the first weapon, he's just got to feel so happy with that. He's ready to take on any scenario, as long as he's got some materials and can ramp rush his opponent.
Fingers are going to be crossed for some shields.
Look at that.
Some minis right out of the gate. Just drink two of those away. That actually puts him in a pretty good spot. I mean, he's the kind of player who, if he found a big shield, the 50 instead of the minis out of the gate, he might have sat and held on to those.
Yeah.
He doesn't have to now. He can be at 150.
And here's exactly what I was talking about. The ramp rush right away.
The pump.
Okay.
And that's one down.
Well, hope you had a good game there. wait for game two of game three, I guess, my friend.
Boogie bomb early. He's pretty low on AR ammo. His opponent kind of rattled a couple of those rounds off, just hoping for maybe a headshot or two to take a kill, but no such luck.
This is where I remember one of the first times him and Drake played together. They were in this area of the map. As he's going ahead and swapping to make sure he's got the blue AR. There you go. But this stands out to me, being in this cabin by Lonely Log.
This is where I think he and Drake talked about how Drake had watched some of the clips of his on Instagram,
yep.
Right?
Yep.
Brings back so many memories.
Really does. As here's more of these chests. He knows these loot spots. I don't think I've ever been here on the map. And wow. Okay.
Come on, man.
Yeah.
People are gonna start to know.
But now he's got to think. Do I use it right away? No. So he's gonna save it. So he's thinking, I would rather get in a fight, get weakened, and gain all the extra health and benefits of a chug chug than just use it for 50 shield and then potentially lose it in the next fight.
Honestly, probably a good call. Better that than like you said, this early, there's still a lot of opportunity to find a large shield and top off and not waste a chug jug, the best heal in the game.
And again, that is a confidence play. That is him from the start of the day. If that was the first game, I think he would have used the chug jug to be at 200 for the next fight. Now, as the day's gone on and he's realized, wait, I'm still Ninja and I'm still averaging like 5+ kills a game.
Yeah.
I think I can get away with only having 150 or waiting to see if I get a big shield before using this.
So he did drop the boogie bomb earlier. He's stuck with the impulse nades. Do you think that's a good call against players that are potentially playing a lot more confident?
Oh, okay. So he's actually going to...
He's gonna greet it. Probably grab the med kit, go in with med kit and minis, which at this point, probably a good idea. It's not often you're going to be able to find a med kit. You want to try and run in your next engagement with as much HP and shield as you can.
Yep.
So utilizing the chug jug in the long run, probably a smart idea. But, you know, the opportunity for a large shield to be found, if it did happen, actually, if it does happen at this point, I guarantee you, you're going to see a look on his face of displeasure.
And just to keep everyone at home, you know, in the loop, I'll wait to hear exact updates on, you know, if Myth is still in play or not. Right now, I'm looking at our other server feeds. I don't see Myth right now, but sometimes we don't have his feed brought up. But again, we will keep you up to date on if you can expect to see him still in this map. The benefit of landing all the way out here with all these trees, look at where he's at with materials already. This is absolutely the quickest we've seen him get to numbers like this in the material category.
Any fight that he runs into at this point, if he fails to build, that's the only way building is going to cause a loss.
Yeah.
Right? He's over 800 wood, 83 brick. That'll come up here as he finds more stone to harvest, and 160 plus metal. He's sitting in a really, really good spot right now.
As we'll wait to just to confirm for everybody, No Myth is not dead to the trolls in the chat trying to spread rumors. He's still alive in game. As Ninja will continue to rotate on here, the first zone pushing in. Actually, how close is he? Right now, we don't even see it on the map.
I don't think he's looked too much either. From the look of things, he might have a little ways to go. I hope he's got his frequent flyer miles saved up. Get him there a little faster. Passing on the hunting rifle.
He's going back to the double heal strat.
Yeah.
Oh,
maybe not. There it is. Picks it up. A bit of a mix up there on moving his gear around, but things are squared away now. And remember, if he does win this game, $2,500 goes to the Alzheimer's Association. And then 2,500 rolls over to the next game for the elimination. He took a hunting rifle shot at somebody coming out of Wailing Woods. misses, and a build fight actually occurring.
Like, right, yeah, he's like, forget like this.
He started a fight there. A little instigation, it looks like.
And now I'll leave them alone.
Oh, I'm gonna go to the zone.
I'm in the zone now. Bye. Have fun, guys. As he'll take this moment to move towards this area. In the next few seconds, you should see the edge of the zone appear on his mini map as he's closing in on it quite quickly, and still with 2 minutes for the storm to push. He's
plenty
absolutely fine. Yeah.
Plenty of time. But an early move is going to be a smarter decision. You don't want to be caught with your pants down, running away from the zone. Any fighting outside the zone, which actually I would like to point out, we've seen barely any of that.
Yep.
He's been playing way inside the zone pretty much every round. You can see, there you go, just past retail row is going to be safe. He does have some building up in front of him, potentially a player left in the area, so he's going to kind of be on guard there, looking around left and right, trying to check to see. There is one back there at the campsite. Hey, little buddy, you look lost in the woods. What's going on?
There's a tomato man looking for you.
As stuff of nightmares,
yeah,
to be quite honest.
This skin is actually pretty scary, not going to lie. As he'll just disengage for a second, and I think, again, he's just going to continue to rotate on over.
The zone is high on the priority list.
Yep.
You can see he's pushing his way the rest of the way in. But what will probably happen...
Myth just got in the limb on someone, by the way, just to keep...
Myth taking out Exotic... Actually, taking out Exotic Chaotic was another a player from previous. And it looks like right now, goal is probably just to get in the zone and then edge guard a little bit, try and play a gatekeeper to anybody that's going to come in. Because like we saw, there were a number of fights going on outside of the zone, where he was, the path that he was taking in. So he has an opportunity to secure some kills, potentially get their loot, if he does build up here in just a second. And there is a hill in front of him.
And you brought up earlier, you actually asked Ninja yourself, do you think Myth is going to go with his normal skin? There it is. He did.
Oh,
he's got the Skull Trooper on, the Scythe out. And yeah, the crowd getting behind it now. These are two of the biggest names in all of Fortnite. As you see Myth getting shot at. Ninja on the left side of your screen, Myth on the right side. What a collaboration this is.
Now you notice the locations. We have retail and fatal. They're pretty much opposite sides of the map.
Yep.
So almost like it was playing into what I wanted to have happen. Don't tell anybody, but these guys coming down to 1v1 at the end would be... Okay, let me ask the crowd. What do you... Would you be kind of excited he had one impulse left, time to drop that thing, pick up a grenade launcher.
This is his best kit he's had in any game so far.
Absolutely.
He has a jump pad, gold scar. Blue pump, a hunting rifle, and the name.
Play. Maybe better than a green hunting rifle will be advantageous in this position. He does have four minis. He can push the last nine shield, which he talked about earlier. He does like to. Every little bit counts. We've seen one HP wins in the past. There's reasons, Nemo.
Build this fight.
We're just going to spam a little bit of AR there to try and break confidence. And there's the ricochets he was talking about before. Those things are perfect arcs on their way in. The aggressive build, trying to get inside on Ninja and see if he can get into a much better position. Something that playing right underneath him is going to lead to an opportunity, I think. Better and better.
And there it shows. 40 seconds left. Now he does have to travel quite far for this zone. It might be one of those things where he does jump pad.
It could. It appears Myth still playing.
Oh, he gets port-a-ported.
Got port-a-ported. One right in front of him. Myth trying to drop a shotgun blast there on his opponent. And a build fight. Young architect, as they say. Trying to assert dominance with elevation. Knock away the ramps and see if he can get exposed. Is it the build, the edits are always on point,
Every time.
Absolutely. As we're sitting in this two box right now, just so you can see exactly how it's all playing out. Ninja with three kills, Myth with two. And Myth
like
just rotating the ramp.
Just looking around, he's keeping his eyes everywhere that he can. Now, I'd like to reference chat on Twitch right now. I think this is the first time I've seen Myth play at the top of one by one tower. Is that right, Courage? I don't think he's never done this before.
As he's at home right
was
now.
Was the sarcasm too thick? I apologize.
No, I got it. Myth is at home right now with the setup he's got. As right now, yeah. I'm enjoying.
See the contrast in play style. Honestly, because typically Myth is a very methodical, a very strategic player. He will wait for people to rotate. He'll make those kind of plays.
Ninja.
Just running straight past
him. He only has enough for wood.
That's true.
It's not what he needed.
And the zone is right there, which I think is higher on his priority list. But as I was saying, Ninja typically much more aggressive in your face. I'm curious to see how this plays out. Maybe when he knows he's running into Myth, if Ninja's play style changes dramatically.
I will say this is the first gas or storm that's now moving in for the next one in a minute and a half that is in favor of Ninja. You see, he's already there.
It's been a while since we've seen him in a good position.
Oh, he's just been playing a running simulator for
exactly.
The last few minutes.
Exactly. It's like the PUBG is calling him back, isn't it? I'm kidding.
There's the look at his brand new pickaxe.
He's ready to cut some pizza, man. Yeah. You can see there's a number of structures down there on the right side. That little car hill, typically somebody, and there actually is a person sitting up top. The hunting rifle gets the body shot, 80 shield damage. And he's going to push forward, try and drop some nades. And he said in the past he loves being aggressive with that thing, trying to get the air burst to open up the top, maybe sneak one inside, finish the kill.
Down to four rockets, keep that in mind.
A player, unless they heal, has a maximum of 120 HP remaining, which means a grenade or two could finish that with ease.
Smart there to repair the repairs the floor.
Oh,
and that hits
one.
Him direct, and that is. All Ninja, that's his best trait, right? Right there, is these well-placed grenades. So frustrating. It's one of the few weapons that you can't really outbuild.
Exactly.
Well-placed.
Now, he's out of grenade ammo. So the next option, especially because he does have the zone on his side, but the launch pad could get him in if he wanted to play a little more invasive. He could try and go for the snipe like this. He can do a little peek in and out. You can see him kind of just maintaining movement the whole time. The last thing you want to do is be too static for too long.
Chat, Myth hasn't moved, okay? We'll show you if something happens. I just see everyone going, Myth, please, Myth. He's done is rotated his ramp
Don't
six
worry,
times.
Guys. He's in the same one
okay?
by one tower.
He's literally just rotating it over and over. Again, Ninja's got the zone. This is where it's now going to be up to someone to try to challenge him up here. Because he's in a fantastic position.
He's going to have to make a decision, though. At a certain point, there's going to be an engagement. He's talked about in the past taking the opportunity when two people are fighting to kind of become the janitor, as you say, and just sneak in, close out on both kills simultaneously. You know what I mean?
Sure.
And right now, there was some gunfire a little bit ago. He could position himself, but I think he's just going to keep tapping away, see if he can close on the one target on Car Hill still.
And we always have referenced ammo so far today. The nade launcher, he's out.
He's
out of ammo. Pretend like he doesn't even have that weapon right now because he can't do anything with it. As he'll just go ahead and continue to be passive up here. Another Myth update. He's rotated his ramp three more times now, putting him in double digits.
So top tier plays.
You can literally hear the zone right at Ninja's back.
23 seconds. A little stormy out there. And here you go for chat and those that are here in the audience.
I wasn't lying.
Courage actually was telling the truth. So there you go. Confident, top of the tower play.
Love how we just did that to be like, stop. Look, he's still there. But again, the storm now closing on in. Where is the next circle? And ooh, it's in the middle for almost everyone. And talk to me a little bit about the dynamic where it basically goes direct to the middle. There's really no
safe area, right?
There's not really. So Ninja's going to have to make decisions. The earlier you move, the better opportunity you have to take a powerful spot in the middle of the circle. However, if you wait long enough, you can play the edge and potentially pick players as they're doing the same thing. They might not have as much shield or HP as Ninja does. They might not have a confident shot. And it's up to Ninja to decide what the best opportunity, what's the best play to take advantage of his position and the knowledge of his opponents. Remember earlier, he was just shooting at someone to the northwest. He's now shooting at somebody to the southeast a little bit. So he knows on either side he's got targets he can take advantage of if he waits to strike at just the right time.
And that's exactly what he's waiting to do. His hand's going to be forced very, very soon. And I'm wondering if...
What? The shot! What? 184 meters, the green hunting rifle.
Putting on a little bit of a show right there.
A little
there,
bit of confidence
folks.
There. Feels good, man.
And if that was him at home, he would have probably jumped up and down in his pajamas, but here, not the case. Another one!
98!
Don't sit still when you're in a lobby with Ninja.
We're looking down from above. He knows that there's one more target in
Don't
there behind
it.
The tree.
Don't
do it. No, do it.
Don't
just do it.
Stop.
Listen, do it. Just hit the shot.
Oh.
An opportunity missed. Maybe. Wait for it.
At this point, I'm assuming he's going to jump pad out of here.
Build up.
Right?
The look. He's waiting the last second. He kind of has to.
Yeah.
The build outside. I think he's securing, trying to wait, make sure that there's enough HP on those that if he needs to push out and jump on him, he can, and not risk getting knocked down immediately.
For sure.
5 seconds in the zone. It's right next to him. Putting the window down. Here's the door. There's the launch pad. And away we go.
All right. This is where the game will begin to escalate. Ninja now moving in towards the middle. 14 players remaining. One of them is still Myth, who's actually in a fight of his own on the other side of the map. Ninja soaring on in. He's now in the middle of the safe zone. He's got that mountain just above him.
This is going to be a good opportunity for him to build up. You know he's playing for the win still. He's not being overly aggressive, but he did like the last couple engagements. He saw an opportunity to take advantage, distraction.
Oh my God! Myth just fell off the map!
Myth just fell off the map. Did not stick the landing. Chad, if we could press F to pay respects. Rest in peace, bud.
Myth just fell off the map.
Well, based on what he said earlier, that's the one game that he's going to lose in this heat, right?
Oh my goodness. I'm sure we could probably pull that from one of the replay feeds after this. That'll be in the
highlights.
In the highlights. Don't worry.
That edit a little awkward just because the position on the metal. No shield left on the target. Almost no HP. And
the pizza man in the window.
he was even blocking his own line of sight just because of how tight that little building was. It was tough for him to see exactly where the guy was. He kind of had to adjust and find the target again because his own character was blocking line of sight. Shots from above. He's going to have to worry about this guy, too. Pretty good shot. Getting pinched from both sides. 88 HP remaining. He's got 3 minis. An opportunity to kind of close himself off, hopefully not get shot down from above. That player building up to try and get the height advantage. Let's see what he does.
Top 10, 6 kills to his name. Got the minis off, already feeling more confident. The big thing too, more grenades in hand now. He's just trying to peek that big shield. There you go. That's actually 2 big shields. How many minis did he have? Is he going to hold on to the big? It looks like he will for now.
I think at this point is... attention is probably more focused on where the heck this guy is scooting to. He's got to take advantage of maybe the zone position. He's got to move relatively soon. 11 seconds left. But when the circles are this small, he can just out. He can outrun him with ease.
Look at his materials.
That's true. 118 wood, and that's it. He's got 11 builds that he can do, 11 surfaces, and that's it.
11 surfaces.
And here we are into a build-off. Another one from up above. A tight position, the pinch between, and he can't close up that wall because the RGC is going to try and knock it down potentially. He's going to go in for the kill, gets the headshot on Logan going down.
And look at the materials. 600
Boom.
Plus wood instantly. That
Yo,
is
Logan,
his chance.
Thanks for the wood, bud.
Yeah, and that's his opportunity now to remain confident in this game. He's going to pop the med kit right away. This will put him at 166 HP. I'm assuming he's going to use the big shield
He'll
as well.
Use shield as well.
I guess
no
you could
tech.
Would you call this technically a mistake not using the big shield first because 5 seconds to get the extra 34 health? But that's like min-maxing, I think. think, essentially. Now he'll go ahead and pop it. So he'll be at 200. Top 8 scenario. Folks, is Ninja going to win this game right now?
I have a good feeling about it. Potentially his greatest competition, Myth, already out. Like you saw earlier, pointed out in the feed. He died to fall damage. He maybe got knocked out from underneath. We'll have to watch back through that.
I watched it. He was shaking his head a lot after that game. Not happy.
Well, let's see if for the two of them, Ninja can close out his game. 7 kills, 7 left, 1 minute on the zone, and grenade spam AR from the other side. He's in a kind of a tight spot. He's going to have to figure his way out of this one.
Essentially, everyone's surrounding him right now. This is who he's in the fight with on the right side of your screens. Stabsy. Frantically building.
Oh, chucking it. A nade back. Muscle. The disco.
Imagine if that was an actual grenade and it landed inside.
Things could have gone south quickly. That was actually an impressive throw. It was right in the window.
Yeah, while moving.
Yeah.
He was basically just eyeballing that one. Now again, looking to have these grenades explode in the air, and there you go.
He's going down.
He makes it look so easy. How about another?
If he gets another one.
Oh, look at me. My name's Ninja. I know how to grenade people. He's not.
Ridiculous.
He wasn't balanced. Ninja wasn't balanced.
Epic, please patch this man.
4 left, including Ninja. He sees at least one on the very high ground. And
Launchpad, 12 HP, almost got dropped. Here we go. See, he can hear his opponent hit the launch pad as well. Trying to locate him.
He's not
inside the zone. He's got to move here. He has very little time. Hopefully he doesn't run into anybody down here. Just let him fight it out. This is his best bet right now. Don't forget, I think there's a window to his right back behind him. You don't want to get shot through that.
3-2, 1v1.
1v1 situation. Win number 2.
Sneaky Beaver versus Ninja. 2 very stealth-like people. My god. I just don't know how much health Sneaky Beaver still has. He obviously just got in a fight, but I can't tell. Here comes the heal. He'll be at 75. Not ideal for the final 1v1.
A risky spot, too, of course. He could have dropped down and got an angle from any of the sides. There was no the building you see there underneath all those structures. It's exposed.
Yeah.
So a shot in the leg counts just as much as the rest of the body. So you're 75 HP. You've got 9 grenades left. Do you think with the elevation of this engagement, those are going to come into play here? Or at this point, I'm feeling like this is a shoddy push.
Uh-oh. He was going for it for a second, but I think he saw just how high up this player built to and realized, nope.
Is he doing what I think he...
Oh my goodness.
Is he going to try and knock it out from underneath and bring the whole thing down? Because if he does, if he pulls this off, grenade spam, you see the ramp, player coming in. He's going to edit.
Whoa, they both launched! It's a high ground battle. Ninja with the advantage right now.
Elevation.
He's got the shotgun out. Both players building for high ground. It looks like Ninja's got it. He's out of materials. He is out. He has to win from this position. Ninja has lost all ability to build from here. He's going for it, folks. 66 HP. One well-placed pump shotgun shell could make the difference here. We do not know how much health his final opponent has. Ninja still dancing around. He's going to use his 2 final grenades. And well, those just hurt the storm, I think. But back to the action. 1v1, shooting out the ceiling. Trying to just get an eye on where this final player is. He hasn't spotted him as of yet. Look at how tight that zone is right now. Ninja, with 7 materials in total, cannot build a thing, and he knows that. If he gives up this high ground, he cannot build back up. He'll go for the extra 9 HP, putting it at 75 in total, and he's worried about getting in a pump shotgun fight too, Lupo, because one shot
is all
enough.
It's going to take. He's still trying. He's trying to find him.
Yeah.
And honestly, every time he walks over that floor right there, I get a little nervous because if there's holes in it, it's not full HP.
Yep.
His opponent could potentially see him up from underneath, and there's nothing supporting it. So if if he knocks that down, they're just going to fall, potentially take enough damage to die.
Here it is.
The zone's going to close in a little bit more, and at some point, there's the rebuild. He knows that the guy's right underneath him.
Ninja cannot do anything. His opponent, you
see
there.
The best angle we have on him right there through the camera on the bottom left of your screen.
And he's got health and shield, so HP advantage absolutely to the opponent right now.
Blue pump, though. Ninja has the opportunity to just close out with one hit, and this guy might wait it out, but at the HP they're at, right now, and you'll see his opponent doesn't have any bandages. No, nothing to heal HP with, and that's all the zone does damage to. So if Ninja waits and plays this out at the end, there's no way he can know this, but he could bandage through and win this.
This is it, ladies and gentlemen. Ninja trying to go for this one now. It's pump shotgun time. We know how good his accuracy is. Ninja, one versus one. 5,000 on the line for this player. If he kills Ninja, he peeks a corner, gets weakened. Ninja down to 30 HP. He'll take some damage from the storm. 5 health in total. Oh. No!
Sneaky Beaver closing it out.
How weak was he? Was he weak? Okay, I could have. I should all in.
$5,000 to Sneaky Beaver there. Oh my goodness, another second place. Ninja, when you ran out of materials, what was going through your mind?
So I knew that I had to try to keep the high ground, man. I accidentally fell down to the bottom, and at that point I was like, okay, I'm going to have to engage him. My goal was to just pop bandages. I actually wasn't even going to try to fight the guy. I was just trying to scare him, maybe see if I can put him in a bad spot or if he forgets to build. But I was going to just use bandages at the end and try to just heal through it.
Yeah, he had, I believe you confirmed, right? There was no healing left.
Yeah, he had no healing for HP left, and you had the bandages.
That's what I wanted to do. That's what I wanted to do, but again, I fell. I fell.
I will say the moment you entered the ceiling open and put down the launch pad, you both flew up at the same time, kind of switched positions. Yeah. It was insanity.
It was beautiful, right? It was like a ballet almost.
It was.
Now, I don't know if you know, but Myth fell off the side of a mountain.
Yeah, he fell and died.
Thoughts on that?
Dude, I mean, I just hope he's got good health insurance, man. Pay for those broken ankles, you know what I'm saying? Like, no, that's. I don't think. I think something might have happened to his mouse or something like that. I looked over when it happened with a big smile, and he seemed kind of upset. So yeah, I'm not sure if he was shot out or anything like that. But
or
I
think his chops.
Yeah, he's. I can see it right now. He's already coming up with an excuse. How do I tell everyone that I fell off the map? Like, what do I do? How do I let everyone know that I didn't get that many kills and I fell off? You know, so, you know.
No, it's all in good fun.
I know.
What is that? So now, another second.
God, all right, Courage. Jesus, man.
I'm just saying. We got to bring it up. I guess we'll also just show the kill again. We might as well. Let's take a look at it. Add insult to injury.
It's going to be, 10 times? Yeah. I just thought I had that shot, man. And right here, I was like, okay, I'm dead. And then when he missed that shot, I was like, all right, I got this. And then he made a great play being aggressive over here. Didn't expect him to do that because he was playing super passive. Oh, look at him. He's so excited, man. Let's go.
Smart from him too to immediately recognize that you had no shields left, brought out the tack. He knew that even if the tack is peppering, it's a quick little kill. Yep. But I believe we have Jess on the floor with our winner, Sneaky Beaver, who's now $5,000 richer.
Oh my gosh, that was the performance we were waiting for. I mean, it was like, that was the Ninja that we're used to seeing on stream, right? But still didn't take the win. Sneaky Beaver came in here, staying true to his name, and he just dominated. Tell me, what were your thoughts in those final couple of moments playing with Ninja?
I mean, I didn't know who I was against, but I knew someone was above me. So they didn't notice me on the bottom, and I didn't have that much stuff. So I got to sneak in. They kept fighting each other. I'm like, I'm going to let him fight. And I'm just going to clean up. And then, I don't know, he jumped at it, and I was just like, oh, no, I lost height advantage. It got really scary, and then, I don't know, I hit my shots, you know. I'm not worried about the shooting. It was just losing height advantage. So that's cool.
Oh my gosh, I mean, it's not often that like people are that nervous watching Ninja thinking that he's gonna lose it and possibly choke, but I was watching it like, I don't think he's gonna get this one. It was crazy. You had him down to 5 health and you had health advantage as well. So what were your strategies throughout the entire game?
I mean, you had to play a little bit different because you're playing like everyone knows how to play. So I was just trying to let everyone fight, and then I clean my kills when I had to take them, and then just, you know, play it to the end, play normal, I hit my shots, I know I'm going to do that, so as long as I get into the shotgun battles, I'm not that nervous in that situation.
Well, you did a great job. Congratulations on winning $2,500. I'm going to take it over to Sue, who is with TSM Myth.
Thank you very much, Jess. Do we have any Myth fans in the house? Myth, let's talk about what happened in this game, because it seems like everything was going smooth for you. So up until your death, how are things going?
The game was going really well. I noticed that the center of the circle is going to be placed on the northern hill that is above a flush. So I was going to just play that early on early. I got the early game. I was going to play the high ground early, and then so then I got the position. I got the position that I wanted it, like I wanted. I wasn't contested. And then as the circle kind of shifted away from the hill, I decided to, there was a player playing underneath me. So we got into a little skirmish, and then off the side of the hill, I like encountered one of the rarest bugs in the game, which is like when you make an edit or like build something, it'll just fling you off. And so that happened, and it was really unfortunate.
You know what? Epic probably heard how confident you were prior to this heat starting, and they just wanted to handicap you.
Yeah, but I get down to it. Like, it's not even like a good fight or anything. I just died to a bug. Like, it's unfortunate, but that's the name of the, like, it's early access, so.
Well, earlier when you spoke with Jess, you were saying that at the minimum, you want to win two games. Now, there's only two games left in this heat, so, I mean, the pressure's on.
Yeah, I still hold up to that.
Now, last question before I let you get back to your seat. This heat is really interesting. There's a lot of great players out. What is it like to have this opportunity to not only be here at the special event Ninja Vegas 18, but also have the opportunity to be going up against these guys?
Yeah, so building up the competitive scene and kind of developing relationships with players that are really passionate about the game when it comes to playing at a high level is awesome. And being able to finally meet these players, talk to them in person and whatnot is super, super, super refreshing. And it's probably my favorite, one of my favorite reasons for coming out here is meeting some of the players in the competitive community and just showing much love to them.
Well, it's very clear they have the utmost respect to you. So good luck in games 2 and 3. Let's head back to the casters.
It's funny watching Tyler. You're there listening to the interview, reacting live. Did you ever expect to see this many eyes on Fortnite this early on in regards to, I mean, this is the first thing of its kind.
Yes. Yes. No, I don't think anything has really taken over this quickly by storm, you know, I say infecting, and it's kind of like a negative way, but truly just infecting the world with you know, epic fun.
Yeah.
Pun intended.
We caught you on that
pun
one.
Pun intended.
I think here in a moment we'll look back at the highlights, but we saw Myth's play there. He's saying it's this bug. He's saying this.
Oh, dude, I'm not sure if it was a bug or not. It definitely looked like it, but what I think happened is that when that edit popped up, I think that might, and then the other player put the ramp above him. I think that edit pushed him back.
Yep.
And then he just kind of slid off. It's super unfortunate, man.
As he said, he does it with a big smile on his face.
I believe.
Super unfortunate.
Yeah. Super unfortunate for Myth. I believe Myth. Myth's a great player. He's played almost probably, if not more, hours than I have in this game. So he thinks that was a glitch. I definitely believe that it happened. So let's take a look at some highlights, man. I had some great fights. You watch this. Boom! Oh, dude, I love impulse grenades, man. They're hands down my favorite.
He's not being overly aggressive, but he did like the,
oh,
the
God,
last
Ben,
couple games.
So good.
He saw an opportunity.
I appreciate that. Here you go.
Advantage.
Here's Myth, the edit. And
you
see his POV. He didn't see the ramp go up above him.
Yeah.
But here you go. This is a much better.
It looks like he goes to jump and hits the ramp, which obviously.
He jumps, hits the ramp, and slides off.
Watch, boing.
Yeah.
And there it is. That's all it takes. He tried to put the floor down to stop himself and ended up, he had phased through it, it looked like. I believe that was his flat surface that he passed through. It's still placed, though. By the way, your grenade plays from within this box were insane.
Oh, you're complimenting you. Him? You're complimenting him?
I know luck when I see it. He got very lucky repeatedly here.
Kind of. It's a trend. Oh, that pump shot, man.
Oh, I did too. I thought I had that shot, too. And I thought I had that shot, too.
But I saw you go to the zone.
I had that shot, too. No, that was definitely GG's, man. Good fight.
I like to point out the one game you've won so far. You had the headband on. Where'd it go?
Dude, it's coming in hot after I win the second game.
All right,
and then I'm waiting for the third.
Okay.
These are just great players, man. I had so many good fights. I'm just excited. Two more games left.
It's all smiles here as you see our live reactions. We're having a blast. I mean, it's great to be here celebrating. You know, something that we all love to play every single day and stream. As you guys know at home, done with Heat 1, done with Heat 2. We're midway through Heat 3. We still have two more games to go. That final game worth $5,000 more on that bounty. Who will claim it is the question for now. Still the one thing that remains, Ninja or Myth, who will get the first victory in Heat 3?
You can see here a list of game winners from all the previous games played up until now. Blind taking home 2 back-to-back in Heat 1. Saint took game 3 in Heat 1. Ninja winning his first one, the first game of Heat 2, and then Punisher, Pain, and Sneaky Beaver. And right now we're at a viewership record for Ninja's channel, actually. I believe it was 655,000 people watching on his channel, which...
Just a few.
That's a couple. That's a couple people. Yeah. So no pressure, Tyler, but there's some eyes on you, my friend.
And again, thank you to everyone watching and supporting this great event, Ninja Vegas 18. Live from the Esports Arena, Las Vegas. I've been having an absolute blast. Again, shout out to all the production, the people behind the scenes making this all possible. Everyone has been so hands-on and ready to have fun at this event, but man, 665,000 live viewers. I mean, what does that prove to you?
Mitch Myth actually pointed out earlier that this kind of the number of eyes on an event like this, it's not a tournament, but this is a good lead in to events that could turn into something like that.
Yeah.
That's a lot of people. There's a lot of attention. Hopefully overwhelmingly positive, because I'll be very honest with you, production here has been, they've been top notch. Things have been going off without a hitch, fingers crossed. And I have a feeling we're going to keep seeing that throughout the rest of us.
Literally, all I could, it's crazy how much this is making me want to go home and play and stream myself. But that'll be at a different point. For now, though, it's time for game number 8. So far, Ninja has one victory, $2,500 going to the Alzheimer's Association. It's time to get another game started.
Can we hear from the arena whether or not you think Ninja's going to take this one home?
Come on, wow, people. They're losing faith.
Woo!
All right, I see you. I see you in the red shirt up there standing up. He's got some dedicated ones out there, but I think it's split. It's split right now. It's a sold-out arena, 700-plus here live at the Esports Arena Las Vegas, as Ninja soars on into his location of choice to continue his gameplay. Every game he's had basically 5-plus kills outside of the one that he exited early on. Did he see anyone?
I don't think he did. And his first drop here in Junk, and we'll see. This is actually a pretty good spot to land early game if you know nobody else is going here. You see, already a blue pump shotgun.
Yeah.
He's got a full med kit, an AR. There's a lot of materials. There's more planks just sitting around than I think I would anticipate in an area like this. He did bypass the basketball, which is disappointing to see. I'd rather see him, you know, try and shoot some hoops, maybe work on his athleticism a little bit. But instead, I think he's just going to play Fortnite, which is too bad.
That's what he's best at, though, as he'll go ahead and find this chest up here. Green SMG, and we haven't seen much SMG gameplay from him today, but what are the strengths of the submachine gun right now in the current meta, in your opinion?
I'm actually a little surprised he didn't pick it up for the bandages instead. A lot of players right now, because of the rate of weapon swap with the pump and just the way that has impacted gameplay, a lot of players are picking up a pump and then a secondary up-close weapon to go with it. And the submachine gun happens to be a pretty hot one right now because it shreds. Up close, you're looking at 40-plus damage on a headshot.
Yep.
And, I mean, let's face it, if somebody has no shields, you hit even just a little bit with a pump action, it's two headshots to take a player out.
Boom.
But it looks like the tack and pump combo is going to be his go-to for now.
It's such a deadly combo. And then you add in the impulse grenades. It is so tough to hit a player when they're soaring through the air. And with how accurate Ninja is, when he can go for those advantageous kind of aggressive plays with the impulse nade, we saw earlier what it can do for him with that one quick pump and the cleanup kill.
Things get scarier too when you turn into a Triceratops, so I think that's the reason for the skin choice.
That is true. He's been practicing a few times with the skin, and he's gonna search for minis first, and there you go.
The streamer luck still turned on, it seems. Gonna top himself off, 100-100, put himself in a really good position for the rest of this game. Now, it appears Myth hanging out in Lonely Lodge already has 2 kills, though.
Yeah.
So Lonely again, that's where Ninja went last game. Ended up being a hot drop yet again. And these two players still opposite sides of the map, basically, both on the north side. But the advantage here, I think, the player that's in a better position, Ninja, he's at full HP, full shield.
Yeah.
He doesn't have to worry about getting body shot by a snipe. He doesn't have to worry about getting rocketed or grenaded out immediately. The only thing that I think that could take him out this far outside the zone might be himself. Fall damage already claimed one of their lives last game. It could strike again.
You see Myth on the right side of your screen, basically just farming every material possible. As he's someone that I think of anyone in the game. Once he gets materials, his entire game plan can change. If he's more than happy just to farm on up now, he's using that kind of
trick to farm just a little bit faster there.
Yeah.
And he's got Myth actually has a hide behind the Christmas tree, and we'll think he might just wait.
And just to set the tone for how known Myth is for this skin, any player that encounters this skin right now is assuming it's Myth. I can promise you that.
He's building up a little one by, see if he can get above the other player as they're pushing up too. Back on the attack shot coming out. Can't see damage numbers on that, but that player now hiding underneath the structure. I'm gonna assume that shield might be gone for that for his opponent. So, more defensive play is probably what you're gonna see here. Myth However, it looks like he's playing a little little bit more aggressive than I would expect from somebody with 74 HP and no shield.
For sure. As I think he's going to kind of reset that battle on the right ninja. On the left side, he's still more than good at full HP as well.
Just hanging outside.
Oh!
And Myth goes down. An AR. Couldn't tell what color it was, but it was not a scar. Potentially a headshot in there. It looked like two hits, and that was it. Two kills, Myth out at 47th, 48th, something like that. Pretty early loss. Too bad.
Okay, so again,
that
Ninja,
puts Ninja in a much better spot now.
Since Ninja doesn't have streamer mode on, I'm wondering if he even this time he didn't react. Last time when Myth died, he looked over, you know, gestured at him. This time, no reaction.
Nothing. He does seem far more locked in right now, potentially, than he did last game. Yeah, and we've talked about it a couple times. Oops. His focus has been higher, I think, than we've seen it in many games. On stream, occasionally, as things play out, you know, maybe he's playing extremely well. He has a really high number of kills. He'll kind of, you know, he'll go into the zone. But most of the time on stream, it's very much like it's like he's having a party all the time.
For sure.
But right now, every single game we've seen, it's super focus mode.
And he's having a party, and you're all invited every day.
Exactly.
That should be his example. Having a party and you're invited. That's
you're doing the advertising form right now. Are you getting paid for that?
For this event? No.
No. Is he?
Yeah. No.
He's
got
to
be.
You're part of his PR
department,
right?
I know he's got his management team somewhere around here. They're just thinking about
how to pick you up, clearly.
But with 39 left, he's so far when he's gone for these topside landings, he has been quite lucky with the zone. The two times he's gone near Junk Junction, remember the first time was with that scar. He was in the zone. Now again, here moving towards Pleasant. Again, for viewers at home, it's just an updated reminder, Myth is out of this game already. As Ninja's got 1,000 materials, he's sitting pretty right now. Full shields, not only with full shields and health, but then you added he's got 2 med kits and another big pot. He's good to heal through so much right now.
And he's, like you said before, he's sitting on the 2 healing slot kind of setup. We noticed that during Heat 2, he didn't play that way too much. Yep. And that is where he secured a win. Now, back in Heat 3, do you think it's a confidence change because there's a more notable player in the games with him that he's playing a little differently?
I think it's one of those things where it's like until he comes across that one item that he wants over the healing options, he values healing over it. And what I mean by that is if he gets a grenade launcher right now,
he's going to pick it up.
If he gets a sniper, he's going to pick it up. But right now, his... you know, like engagement swings. The item he has to swing a fight in his favor is that impulse. Are the impulse grenades? And there's that SMG that we talked about earlier. Ironically enough, someone now using it against him. It shreds through walls.
Very good at taking buildings down. Yeah,
yeah.
And that's why they were spraying away with it. A lot of people will use explosives or an AR spam if that's all they have. But an SMG it kind of excels. He's trying to drop the surface out from underneath them. That second last one just shot out.
Oh no!
SMG spray.
The second I saw him jump,
things went south.
Yeah.
Finishing the big heal. He has an opportunity. I think he's going to try and push with an impulse nade. If that player.
I think he's
going to
knock the ramp and then make the play happen.
There we go.
Oh, okay.
A little build up.
He's going to get outbuilt. He's got impulse. He messed up the impulse grenade.
Caught himself. 93 remaining.
No more shields. The med kit for only 7.
And if he needs to get out of here quick, he does have the launch pad. Kind of expected it gonna get shot at as he's trying to swoop away here.
Standing by watching just like the hundreds and hundreds of thousands of you at home.
Now you gotta remember, I mean, any of these competitive players, even if they get knocked out, they're still all rooting for each other. That's one thing about Fortnite, and I think everybody here can agree, is it's developed a lot of really good relationships between a lot of these players. So, yeah, Myth might be out, but...
He might not be the happiest watch. He's still looking forward to seeing these people be successful, but
exactly.
His own self right now, he's quite upset.
Crossbow? Come on, brother.
Are you
give
surprised?
Come on.
As he's just completely disengaged that fight, and I think for him, he's kind of viewing that as like an L. If you think about it, he used the big shield. He's lost all of his shields in general now. He's had to pop a med kit too and never got the kill. So that for
still
him, he's going, okay.
That SMG.
Oh, wow. Look at the aggression.
Very, very top-down build. I think he's just going to mine through the top of this, that submachine gun, potentially. And you're playing
he's
out
engaged.
Away from it. Flying away, just trying to keep himself alive. Plus, a minute 10 on the zone before it's going to be time for him to move. Anyway, he's at plus park, kind of far outside.
Oh,
his opponent dropped down accidentally, you think? A little slip there. He's jumping down.
He boogied him.
Boogie bomb.
Disco, disco. Disco, disco.
There
disco,
it is.
Disco.
Logan going down. Good, good. Well done.
Oh, Sneaky Beaver!
Holy shit, man.
Are you kidding me?
The odds of this person being in that specific spot on the map and coming in and cleaning me up after a fight.
So low.
It's like less than 1%.
There's a reason they call him Sneaky Beaver, my friend.
Literally less than 1%. That's insane.
I'm curious to see where he was during that whole fight. Do you think he was in the top of the house?
I have no idea. I don't know where he came from.
Modern, maybe? That's the only thing I can think. That's the angle he came from. But that's now $7,500, one for Sneaky Beaver.
Yeah.
People are making bank, man. I'm pretty pissed about that, dude. I really wanted it. I thought that was good, man. I got that good fight against GS, man. Hit him with a disco bomb, finished him off. Saw Myth die as well, too, early game. I was like, this is going to be another top 10 or top 5 scenario. But, wow. Jesus, dude, this guy has my number.
That's the ninja we're used to seeing on stream after.
Gosh, man.
But no, I'm still happy to see you all in good spirits. I don't know if you heard before, but your personal viewership number was shattered there.
You set a new record on your channel.
665,000 viewers there. What are your thoughts on that, man?
Dude, man, that's amazing.
Give it up.
Thank you so much, guys. And thank you for everyone watching. I just hope everyone's enjoying the event, man. The energy here in Vegas is...
I'm going to answer. They are.
Hands down, one of the greatest.
Okay.
Let's put the sappy stuff aside. This man is trying to get some sort of advantage here. You see this tree. I don't know if it is low on HP. It looks like it is. I like it. Dude, look at this reposition. That was his last impulse nade unless he had some of his own. Because I think he picked up mine. But he should have some medkits as well. No idea how many. Actually, I mean, he should have some medkits. This is a great play. Does he have any healing at all? He'd be healing by now, right?
Potentially. It depends on, the position of the opponent. He might not feel confident enough to just sit for a second. You see him running over here. This might be the time to do it.
Yeah, here it is. He's got a medkit. I had a couple on me, so.
Uh-oh. Did he take too long, though? He's now got someone just above him peering on down.
Based on what we can see, it looks like he might have a blue AR, a blue pump, and a gray tack shotty, right?
And he still has,
at least one medkit.
Yeah. Oh, I felt the wrath of the pump shotty, so.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. Oh, cool. Nice. Zone. Let's go. Now he's in a pretty sticky situation, man. He already took some damage from the storm. This player's above him. I mean, he just lost all the high ground, though. I mean, I'm Sneaky Beaver. I'm building up just a little bit higher. There you go.
That's exactly what
we got a little bit of a build up here. Wasn't this one the guys in the... Did I start at the beginning of the game or no? I thought I already killed this person. Is this two like Santa Claus skins?
Might be.
Oh, nice edit. Spooky.
A nice edit.
That was incredible.
Spooky.
Hey man, but dude, listen, I'm Sneaky Beaver, man. I just won, $7,500 total. I'm still happy.
That's our second. Is that our second $7,500?
Second $7,500. Blind killed me and won, and then won.
So I mean, you think that with the bounty and the final game still to come, that's a. Well,
he could win ten grand.
Dude,
I just again, I can't stress how unfortunate it is that we met, and he finished me off like that. Like literally, look how massive the map is. There must have been where he landed the first game too. I'm assuming. I don't know if he's mixed it up or anything. I don't know. I don't know people's strategies.
True. we actually had a little conversation, and I'd love to pick your brain on it for a
second. Absolutely.
You went back to the two healing this game,
yes. But
we were saying, you have the impulse nades.
Yes.
Is it like you're waiting for that weapon to say, okay, I'm going to go back to just carrying minis, for example? If you found a nade launcher, you'd say, okay, I'm going back to one healing?
Correct, absolutely. Okay. When I don't have a power weapon, which is a sniper rifle or a rocket launcher, absolutely, man. You have to go with, you can't, especially from what I'm realizing, like, I've benefited every single game from making the switch to, like, there wasn't a single situation really, truly, where I died because I didn't have a tactical shotgun and a pump. I'm putting myself every time in great situations to win those fights and just kind of making small mistakes here and there. But absolutely, man, in like a very, very competitive solos environment, you need as much healing as possible. You're going to get tagged, sniped, and unless you have that grenade launcher, which you guys saw some magic I worked at the end of that last game to get second. That's how powerful it is, man. End game, all these people who don't have a lot of healing. I killed so many people just with one explosion, right? Like, yep. So they didn't have health, shields. They were weak.
Suck him out, man. How is this guy not getting shot in the back from the person up top? Did he, like, laser him or something?
Who knows?
There's enough only 13 to scare him away, it appears. Yeah, 12 remaining, a minute. The zone is closing, so he's going to make a little bit movement forward.
He's getting that last second farming in, man, before this circle gets even smaller, man. Ooh, dude,
it makes me wonder what kind of materials he's sitting on right now.
It's a really cool pickaxe he has.
Yeah, it's a great pickaxe. I think, Courage, correct me if I'm wrong.
Is that
a Twitch Prime pickaxe?
I think that actually is. That's the new one that was reinstated by
you. How much did he pay for that?
That didn't cost him a dime.
It didn't cost him anything?
Nothing. All he needed to do was link his Amazon Prime account to his Twitch account to receive two free skins, a glider, and a pickaxe.
Wow. Wow, honestly, that's a steal.
Good work. Good work. That was a good alley-oop right there.
Thank
but
you, man.
Right now, Spooky in a rough spot.
Yeah, he's south side, just trying to build and survive.
Good. He already switched away from, oh, he's got to go to, oh, no, buddy.
Oh, no.
Spooky, if he wins this or gets out of this, $2,500.
He's a champion.
From me. Oh. On top of.
You keep doing
we're in Vegas. Let's gamble, boys.
Jess is somewhere in the venue going, honey, no. Honey, please. No.
And he's gone.
Well, close.
Hey,
man, if my luck is, you know, I'm having a pretty lucky night, honestly, man. I can't wait to hit those tables, boys.
Top seven now is we're on board with, I believe it's Merkska.
Yeah, this escalated so quickly, guys.
Yeah, that's
really. Cool. I felt honest, the game just started, man, really.
Has this been the closest to Tilted Towers we've been? It's like just next door. I want it to happen.
Why is it even still there?
Oh,
epic.
Call.
Hello.
The Comet 418. SOS D5.
I thought that was happening.
Force
sure.
code.
Dude, I just want, Epic, if you're listening, man, you guys need to deliver. I want a cinematic. I want to load into Fortnite on like the end of the season, and I want a beautiful, epic HD 1080p LED.
LED!
Cinematic, like. Meteor comes, everyone's freaking out, zombies are like, boom, blows up Tilted Towers.
Just a quick reminder, we have seven left in the game. Myth died early in Wailing Woods in a little 1v1 shootout. It looked like he got, he had like 75 HP, got AR2 tapped, so he's not in this game anymore.
And we're also watching Vape Jesus, who we interviewed prior to starting this matchup. We heard exactly his thoughts, again, how he likes to play a more of a passive role. Again, one of the three Tempo Storm members currently participating in this one. And Vape Jesus, as you see in the bottom of your screen, he's up on the stage right now.
Yep, yeah, Vape VJ Jesus. Yeah, you got him. You got it, Ben.
VJ was actually referenced by Payne. Payne, who won, a Tempo Storm player who won in Heat 2, but as who Payne just switched play styles to. Basically said, VJ plays defensive, and Payne doesn't. Payne is an aggressive player, but he said, you know what, I'm gonna pull a full 180. And go full Vape Jesus on this one and see if I can clutch out a win. And he did. So we could see some big plays from VJ here if he focuses, funnels the same play style that Payne took advantage of.
Absolutely. Yeah, he just got absolutely lasered. I'm seeing a lot of SMG play here. And in my opinion, when you have this intense situation, he's dead for sure. That's a good job.
Good try, man.
You have this intense stage setup, man. I really think that SMG just adds a lot of pressure to players.
We literally brought that up.
Yep.
Not 5 minutes ago.
Yeah,
Tyler.
I love you guys, man. That's why you guys are up there, man. I couldn't ask for a better duo to be casting this.
Thank you so much, bro.
Yeah, no. So that SMG, right? Oh my God, ballsy. This is a risky play. I mean, I reset right now. That's a jump.
No!
What are you doing?
Oh my God. Dude, why did he jump? He just had to fall. I was like, dude, that's a bold strategy. He seems to jump off of the mountain. Let's see how that works out for him.
Sending himself to
you just
game
hate to
nine.
See that happen.
Dude, no way, man. Yo, can we get some ninja splats in the chat, please?
Oh, they're I can promise you, from seeing the spam so far today, they are there. When you use the bush, you should have seen your chat.
Yeah,
so was it worth it? You think it was worth it using the bush, even though I
no, no, absolutely not.
It was a terrible choice. Never do it again. No, it was pretty funny to watch, though.
We were literally talking the strategy about how you were going to take fall damage to get rid of it.
It's exactly what you did.
Dude, you guys are seriously way too good.
Yeah, here we go. Here's one of the final buildups. Top four in this game.
Yeah, I mean, he's super high up right now. This is something
down.
That I think as top players continue to get better, right, and people start to kind of learn the meta, right, is difficult, man. When I see people do these high build battles, I'm literally just, my mouth is watering as a player watching because I just go underneath him and shoot him down.
Do you think, though, he had a couple misplays on that build right there? He should have the high ground. His jump fatigue came.
I was actually going to point that out. It's something that Ninja's talked about with even my gameplay of spamming jump a little bit too much. There's a diminishing cooldown on that. And if you jump too much, then your jump height gets shorter and shorter and shorter.
Really
wait.
Yep.
He could have still had the height advantage. Goodness. Although here,
this is the play I was talking
this
about.
Is the play.
See, I would have done this even earlier. Oh, but that, that's it. He's, dilute delivery system.
Oh, hey.
Let's go, man. Oh, so well done. That was so well done. And that's exactly what I'm talking about. I've been watching a lot of scrims as well on Twitch Moments YouTube channel. They're pulling in a lot of scrim fights, which was with Epic's amazing. With that big, amazing replay system. Yeah. And oh my
what?
God, he got him?
What?
Unbelievable. What a 1v1 situation. On Storm's got four kills. Yeah.
Long story short, a lot of those fights tend to just be building up, and I think a lot of people are going to start just dropping down and shooting him out. So here we go, the last fight. He just got some minis, but I don't think he even cares. I don't think he picked them up. He's just going straight in. He's in such a good position, man. He's 100 health, 50 shields, got minis. Oh my God, that's the game.
Storm for the win!
Brush it off.
Give it up for Storm in the arena.
No, guys, give it up. Let's go.
Wow. Is that it? There you go.
Oh my
well
God,
done.
Let's go.
What a beast.
Unbelievable.
GG.
$2,500 richer right there. Such clutch plays and the maneuvers he made, the smart plays. I think the Rockets, you think, rocketed the one guy out of the tower, then got the rocket kill on the second guy, the final guy, another rocket launcher play. Tyler mentioned it early on in the day, having some explodes does go a long way in these games.
Yeah, I mean, again, this is something that a lot of people are starting to, I think, figure out. Is, I mean, just in general, end game, man, rockets are super important. Clutch two kills. Yeah, and Sue, please interview this amazing kid. That was such a great game. Congratulations.
Thank you very much, Ninja. I'm standing here with a 14-year-old in 40R Storm. Absolutely phenomenal stuff here. When I was 14, I was absolutely useless. You are far from that. $2,500 is yours. What's going through your head right now?
I don't even know what to say. It's just crazy.
And I mean, what were your expectations coming here? I mean, I'm sure you're a Ninja fan, and it was just cool to be here. At what point did you think, I might actually win this game?
I never thought I'd win. I just
I have a question for you, man. In that specific situation, the cue dance when the guy fell in front of you, that was amazing. Did you know that when he fell and you shot that rocket and killed the third last guy alive, did you know you were going to win? Did you feel like confident going that last fight?
I felt pretty confident.
It looks confident, man. It was great gameplay, man. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Seriously, confident indeed, especially for a 14-year-old. Last question before we throw it over to Jess. I mean, you just won this game. You said you didn't expect this, but still you're looking really confident. Headed into game three, can you do it again?
Maybe, we'll see.
Love to hear it. Congratulations again. $2,500 is yours, Jess. Let's head over to you.
Thank you, Sue. Oh my gosh, 14 years old, that's crazy. I know these lights are real bad, aren't they? Especially as the night goes on. So what I have heard is that Sneaky Beaver, you used to play Halo and actually compete against Ninja in Halo. Tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, I mean, we used to go to MLG tournaments. I played them in a few tournaments. I think we matched up against each other. So, I mean, I know him from Halo, and it's just like crazy seeing someone from Halo like come into the PC world and dominate. So I'm just super proud of him, you know?
That's awesome. It's really cool to see a little bit of Halo coming in here, just like Ninja's grown from that. You have now killed him twice, both games in Heat 3. Like, you've gotten to kill him. You've won $7,500 with your win as well. What are you going to do with that?
Build another PC? I don't know. My PC's kind of a little bit toaster right now, so probably build a PC.
Yeah, you can probably build two BC PCs with that, but congratulations. We're really proud of how you've done, and it's been awesome seeing you go. We're going to send it back to the casters. Thank you.
Wow. Sneaky Beaver, $7,500 so far. He's
pretty
one
crazy.
More game to go, but can we talk about 40R Storm?
What a set of plays at the end, including the dance moves, got to say.
What were you doing at 14 years old?
Not that, honestly. Wasting my time, and this kid's out here annihilating.
I literally just tweeted, I was like, a 14-year-old just clutched in for $2,500 in front of Ninja and 650,000 plus people watching online. Ice in his veins.
I think I'm done. I think that shows for me at least it's all downhill from here.
Once that kid grows up even more, you're going to see him on the main stage. Sorry, just get destroyed.
Myth better keep his eyes on him too, honestly.
Right? No, it's. We've got another look again at our winning moment from game two of Heat 3. It all
he's
came down to the Rockets. And,
going
Christian
in.
On the right side
he's
of the screen.
Position, man. He's 100.
You just didn't build? You need to build?
The rocket play to finish it off, and before that even, look at that, dusting the shoulders off. That's what's up. No, it's just interesting to see all the rocket gameplay before that too, dropping the structure down. And it was funny to hear the kid played exactly how Ninja was describing on the fly too.
Oh, look at the use of the replay mode as well. Epic employees who worked on that are smiling ear to ear, but a great view there. Again, shout out to our observers and production team for always being quick and ready with those. But we're through 8 games so far.
One left.
We know of the heightened bounty. You kill Ninja here, $7,500. Still the $2,500 for winning the game. But before we do that, we've got to send it down to Jess on the floor.
Thank you, guys. All right. Ninja, I'm coming up to you. You don't know what I'm about to do, but I'm about to present you with a headband. But you know, if you take this, that means we're expecting a win from this last game of Ninja Vegas 18. Choose wisely. Are you going to pick one? That means you're expecting a win.
Yes.
Can we see a win in this final game of Ninja Vegas 18?
Absolutely.
All right, we're ready to see it.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
You're very attractive.
I'm going to be honest, guys. I think he might stand a chance. we'll probably see him try and get a number later.
Yeah, hopefully. Best of luck with that, man. Shoot your shot 2018.
Good luck.
There it is. There it is. The bandana is on. For maybe people who don't know, what does a bandana mean on your street? Ninja.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. So it's something that I started to do just after I started winning games. I was like, okay, wait a minute. Like, I want to constantly evolve, right? I want to constantly change the game and stream and do all these amazing things. And I was like, hey, how can I enhance, you know, the viewer experience? And it's like, okay, if I win a game, how do people know about a win streak, right? I don't want to have to change my title all the time. I don't want to have to, you know, tweet out and then jinx myself. You know, just won 7 games in a row. So it's like I have the bandana on. That means that players and people who are coming into the stream, they'd be like, okay, Ninja has his bandana on. He's on a win streak, or he just won a game. And you know, maybe it's another reason that people want to stick around. They don't want to see me lose. So that's where it came from.
Well, again, we're looking forward to seeing if we can put to good use here.
We do
know Myth is still in the lobby. Here's the way he died in the last game. I don't know if you got to see this yet, Tyler, but he was at 75 HP for a long, long time.
Yeah, that's super unfortunate. I mean, there's literally...
that look on his face is how I felt inside.
Yeah, that's honestly... I mean, dude, there was a situation... The last game I didn't do very well on. Oh, he got headshotted.
The instant headshot.
Oh, man. Oh, yeah. When you have 75 HP, there is no worse feeling. No worse feeling at all. Your body shot to a hunting rifle, a sniper rifle. I mean, so many things, dude. You're just praying that you don't die.
I mean, it wasn't only Myth that died, though, in that game. Let's take a look at how Ninja died in that last game.
That's the most important.
I just want you to know, Tyler, that I'm being told this by Drew, our wonderful director, in our ears. This is not on me every time.
Oh, no, it's totally fine. Show your I think this might be the wrong one.
This definitely is not you.
But that's totally fine. I like Jumpman.
We can still admire his
Oh, there you go. Look, you got the kill in the kill feed.
Yeah, I got the kill in the
kill feed. This is Jumpman's reaction.
Jumpman jumped for you upon your kill. Congratulations.
There it is.
We're restarting. Drop it down from above.
Oh.
It looks like, as we were talking about earlier, Sneaky Beaver, his location was kind of, puzzling to us at the time. And it looked like right there, he pushed up the ramp that was built from the west side, and the soccer field came down from above with the attack shabby and just took advantage of a situation.
Yeah, I mean, that's super unfortunate. Again, that's a perfect word. I like that word. It's a good word. That's
super
just
unfortunate.
It's just unfortunate. That's unfortunate. You know, I'm just happy still with how I played that game. I played well, made a good play on the other top player that was in the lobby. He definitely... just knew he was good with how he was building, killed him, and it's, you know, I was like, all right, here we go, this is it, I got this, I'm gonna loot up, bam, dead.
One final game. Do you want to say anything? I mean, you've said thank you a ton, I know that, but anything else that's on your mind that you maybe haven't been able to say today as we lead into one final game?
Nah, dude, Esports Arena, man, they've done such an incredible job running this event. This is hands down, 1,000,000%, and I'm not being paid to say this, and I'm actually not. This is the best event I've ever been a part of, hands down. This is the cleanest, smoothest. You guys, the crowd has been absolutely incredible. Everything about it, the production has been insane. It's just amazing, man. And I'm just happy that this is happening. And I just can't wait to close this game out, man. I'm pumped.
No, I know that the work has been put in for months. And I was on calls a couple months ago about this. And now to see it all come to fruition and have so much success. 665,000 live viewers online.
So even before this, like you said, you set a new record today, but your previous record, you were playing with Drake when that happened?
Yes,
right?
Dude. Yeah, man.
You want to talk about that a little bit, how that came to fruition?
Oh, I'd love to, man. Yeah, no, I'd love to. There's a lot of people who don't know about it, but I've answered it a lot of interviews that people will probably see. But it was just so crazy, man. I was playing, streaming my entire chat. Champagne Poppy followed you. Champagne Poppy followed you on Instagram. I had no idea who Champagne Poppy was, that yeah. name, because I was also super new to Instagram.
Yeah.
So then when I said that, it was just like, Drake.
We actually have a video about it. If you want to take a look real quick.
I'd love to, man.
There you go. Let's do it.
I was streaming. It was like 11 a.m. or something. And my entire chat is just like, Champagne Poppy followed you. I'm like, who's Champagne Poppy? They're like, Drake. So I go on Instagram and I type in Drake and nothing pops up. So I'm like, oh, Champagne Poppy, 40 million followers follows me. I'm like, okay. Like, I mean, I sat there with Jess and my wife and I'm just like, this is happening. Like, this, no one hacked his account, right? Like, this is actually happening.
Hi, Drake.
Hi, how are you? Can you hear me?
Yeah, she can hear you.
Oh, yeah, all right. What's up?
He's just doing a backflip real quick. Sorry.
So, yo, I've been watching you for a minute, man. I saw you guys win a crazy like competition. Like,
yeah, you saw that? Nice, yeah. Dude. He's a great teammate, by the way. Dropped me a bunch of wood and stone all the time. I mean, he knew who was going to carry him to victory, which was great.
Let me know if he's reviving his teammate.
Yeah, he is. He's reviving his teammate.
Got it, baby.
Yeah,
boom.
There we go. Let's get it, man.
Let's go, baby.
Did you ever think you'd be in a situation where you get the opportunity to play with Drake like that, man?
Definitely not, man. I really just had a fun time. I think the coolest part about that whole situation was how organic it was, and just really how natural and fun I had. And I think I'm pretty sure you had a lot of fun, too. So.
Oh, I've seen you guys have played again since then, so I definitely believe you on that.
It's
really cool to see that.
Hit the game, though. I think we're here.
It's go time. Last one.
Good luck,
my friend.
Last game. Let's go.
Make some noise.
Give me some hype in the arena, please.
Make some noise. Here it is, the added bounty. Remember, folks, this is our final game. You kill Ninja, you get $7,500, 680,000 concurrent Twitch viewers. I can't even imagine what that even looks like if you saw that many people in person.
Terrifying, most likely. But he has a history of putting on a good show for everybody, so I expect the same thing.
Let's straight to business now.
Jean-Luc.
With the outfit change, I absolutely love to see it. But here we go. Can he win his second game, or will it end in heartbreak?
There we go. Landing shifty shafts. Jean-Luc is often you think they call him the boogeyman, but he's actually the guy you call to kill the boogeyman.
Yes.
We'll see here.
The Reaper skin is definitely a fan favorite out there.
Minis out of the gate, no shotgun yet, and with tight quarters and shifty shafts, shotgun. Almost wired.
Yeah.
Unless he plans on playing on the outskirts a little. This thing is wild. Hopefully we get an opportunity to see it, especially because he's sitting on 130 rounds. He's got only 60 in the AR. He can make some plays here.
Yep. He'll go ahead and loot on up more.
Ignoring the C4 and moving on. We have a blue vending machine. That looked like
what?
Gold Scar. Are you kidding me?
What?
Confidence boost to the roof now. There's still that trap we heard earlier inside Shifty Shafts. Still looking for a shotgun. And that player may have moved out.
And he's got the zone for him.
Does indeed.
Wait. This might be a tilted zone.
This might be a
this
tilted
zone.
He's going to have to push past
zone.
Tilted here in a second.
Dude.
But the
Let's
first
go.
Of all nine games today, we might finally see Tilted Towers.
This is incredible right now. All the stars aligning for this final one. Another chest. More minis.
He's got a Deagle sitting on an LMG and a Gold Scar.
What else can you ask for? Well, shotgun.
A shotgun's going to be pretty
shield,
important.
Probably a chug jug, maybe a grenade launcher.
He probably asked for a snipe of some sort. And
seems
like quite
a lot of things
secure.
He could ask for in this scenario, so I don't know what I'm saying. So he'll go ahead and grab the hunting rifle for the Deagle. And
an intelligence swap out there. He wants some more minis. He wants something for long range. He's going to put the Deagle down. Diminishing returns on range, the damage drop-off kind of it neutered a handful of the weapons. The hard-hitting pistols being kind of the what felt like the biggest target, right? They were, since the patch, I've used the Golden Deagle in Pleasant Park, shooting basically up the West Side Street, and got maybe only a 40 damage headshot, and that felt sad,
yeah,
to say the least.
No, it's definitely one of the major changes that has come into play with the meta. Right now, Ninja's sitting at 471. No way. Is he really? I've just received word that Myth is down. Oh my goodness, folks.
Another early exit.
Is that the biggest takeaway today?
Might be. I mean, it could have been any number of things. Hopefully we can see just how it played out. I guess we're receiving word we don't have it. We'll have to talk to Myth maybe at the end of this game and
wow.
What exactly happened. Get the word from the man himself. But for a first shot at a live event like that, I don't think it's something to take to heart too much. You know, bad things happen to good people, you know.
Listen, he came out to have a good time, and I think he did up to this point. Unfortunately, due to his age, I don't think he can celebrate Vegas too much. Again, we are live here from the Esports Arena Las Vegas. So you can come on over here really any day of the week, use some great computers, you know, rent them on out, and experience what an awesome venue this is. I highly recommend it to anyone who's in this area or travels to Vegas for vacation. This Ninja
shot in the back. Southwest. That player actually goes down, sniped by Acidic 8. You see in the feed down there, last fight, which means he's got a player right in front of him. So these are build-up fights. Going to try and get height advantage, and he kind of does. So the player whipping a shot with a shotgun there, and it looks like a third player maybe coming in, getting hit. 33 HP left. He's got to heal up. He has to take the time before this player tries to get an angle on him. There we go. The scar shots from...
He's getting shot by three players.
He's got one on the hill to his east. He's got one to his west and one underneath him, trying to knock the floor out.
I mean, this player shooting a pistol makes me feel like he's running low on other types of ammo, right?
It would not surprise me at this point. Or he's just using his least effective weapon up close to try and drop out the...
Get juked, my friend.
A little bit of confusion there. No shotgun, still kind of coming back to bite Ninja in the butt right now. We'll see if he can make a play here. Gold Scar, the hunting rifle will be useless up close unless he's feeling real spicy. And the LMG probably not going to get picked up either. That Gold Scar might be his go-to to make it out of this. He still has the other target, the east side hill, looking down on him. A pinch position and not a very favorable one. He's got to make his way out of this somehow.
And again, for now, he's just kind of passively looking down. Uh-oh. He's got the LMG in hand. He's deciding that that'll be his close-range weapon. This thing does a lot of damage when it connects.
Yeah. There it is.
It's
bring
good.
It on Pacific Gate. Good play.
It's a good weapon.
It is. It appears to be a decent weapon.
The rate of fire combined with what? It does 26 damage, 25 damage, which, I mean, and the spread really isn't that bad.
Especially if you're up close like that,
yeah.
Basically point blank.
He's holding on to it. Oh.
Actually, getting shot from the south. 165, another player, another build fight, and he just doesn't get a break here. The attack shotgun phases through the wall, gets the shot.
That was Sicarios. Ninja wants this win. We saw Bang. Jess prior to this game bring out the bandana.
The bandana's supposed to have, we saw earlier he had one on. That was the game that he won.
Oh.
Maybe that's
Here's
the magic.
There's another fight now.
Another challenge. This could be a long, just a quick hunting rifle headshot. This player peeks. Get a little bit of aggressive push there. Goes for it.
Oh my goodness.
Trying to get a very fast quick scope in there and just barely missed. The floor dropped out from under him.
Silver lining for him in these fights so far is that he has gained back some materials. Right now, currently sitting at 700 plus. He's trying to heal as frantically as possible. That'll put him at 125, and there's
another
that SMG,
SMG
again. Just melts those walls.
Or maybe now getting shot at from someone else. An opportunity for Ninja. Could just peek over the top of this. The scar shots. Golden Scar, 36 the shield. This player's still sitting pretty. He's going to get a little more aggressive. He's building. The build has been a little risky. He's been building a lot of one-bys, and that's it. No reinforcement. But here you see he's got height advantage big time. He's got a player stuck underneath him now, and he kind of has to mix it up.
Seems like he just can't get a single one-on-one. Every single one, there's always a third party throwing their name in the hat as you can hear those bullets whizzing by him.
mind right now. Tree out to get visibility on what's underneath him. Which is exactly where the player is hiding. You see him right there through the wood surface. 72 shield. Just looking to close down on this guy. Just trying to drop through. Careful of the traps. Careful of the shotgun play here, too. Player running away down the hill.
He wanted that one right there. And he knows he's got this guy weakened. He has that kind of HP advantage. But he doesn't want to force a pump fight for this reason.
Oh.
Oh. I should have just stayed up. I knew he had no materials, man. He was so weak. It's a misplay. It ends like that, man. You know what, dude? I don't even care. I don't even care. All I want is Mythic to win. All right? I hope he doesn't fall off the map.
I hate to break it to you, my friend, but hey. Myth is out already.
Are you kidding me?
We actually, damn we it, don't even hey. Have footage of how he died. We're going to have to, we'll bring him up in a little bit here at the end of this game to find out exactly what happened.
Dude, I'm so mad, man. I can't believe it. I should have just played way more passive, dude. I knew it.
Well,
the silver lining, though, this player taking home $7,500 and doesn't even know it yet.
Well, you know what? I guess I'm taking this off.
Oh. We saw you went into the.